Hey everyone, the name is Erik Thor, and in today's video I want to talk about the dark side of the INFP personality type. And what is the dark side of the INFP? I think the dark side of the INFP is the tendency to complain. So let me elaborate on that. I think a lot of times INFPs gone bad have a bad habit of crying out to evil gods, you could say. Or you could say INFPs have a habit of looking for and staring themselves blindly at evil and cruelty and higher beings of higher power, of people that have higher power than they do. And in this complaining to people who are higher in power and stature, and also painting these people in a dark or evil light. So when an INFP goes bad, not only does the INFP go into extroverted thinking, their inferior function, to stare themselves blindly at the idea of power conflict, where you are the person who is weak and powerless, and where other people are the people who are strong and powerful. But also, you paint a picture of an idea of yourself as innocent and the people in power as cruel and malignant. Malicious people. So as an INFP gone dark, there is this tendency to paint yourself and people at the bottom of the pile as good and people in the higher top of the pile as evil. And this kind of mentality is interesting, because I think a lot of the time INFPs have, and this is quite interesting to me as an INFJ, a belief in luck. And luck is a really interesting concept, and I think luck is a very powerful concept. I believe if you can believe in luck, you can also believe that you can, you should say, make your own luck, you can make your own future, you can make your own dreams come true. So the INFP light side is their ability to have hope and to believe in luck, and to believe that you can be lucky and that you can have luck, you can have good things happen to you, you can be rewarded by higher beings, by higher power, by a god if you believe in such a thing, or by the people that you see around you that you believe are strong and powerful. I think as an INFP, the idea of luck is a very tempting one and a very cool one, because I think when you believe in luck and when you have hope, you can make the best choices possible. You can make truly idealistic decisions. You can make decisions that an ESTJ or an ISTJ would announce as impossible or stupid or foolish, and you can get a big payoff for it. But of course, you can also, if you have hope, sometimes resign yourself to low cost of the dice. You can sometimes end up with all ones over and over again. And I think when that happens, the dark side of the INFP is quite real and will probably happen to all INFPs at some point of their lives. Just as everyone will have dark days, you will have unlucky days, you will have times when you are not rewarded. And then the question is, why? Why did I roll just once? Why did I get punished by destiny, by the fate, by the higher beings that be, the gods that reigns above, or by the people in power that held me down? You know, why was I forced to get ones when other people get sixes? Why was I forced to be unlucky when other people got it so good? And here you have this feeling of injustice and of being wronged. So the dark side of the INFP is the tendency to complain, and here I mean to speak openly about and to talk about or to grumble about or to find yourself going about all the dark things that have happened to you, all the bad things that you've experienced. You know, It's a very understandable thing, you know, when you are in those situations, when bad things happen to you, to constantly go over those situations over again, you know, to go into the kind of introverted sensing loop of just constantly going over bad scenarios that have happened to you, even counting them up, you know, this happened and then that and then that and then that and then that and that, creating this narrative, this historical experience where everything that has happened to you ever has been bad and nothing that has happened to you ever has been good, and to fall into these loops, because you can have days where you only see the bad and where you only count up all the unlucky things you've experienced. You can have days where you feel incredibly lucky and incredibly blessed, and where you feel like everything that's happened to you has happened for a reason. And often you'll find yourself having both of these things. You'll never be completely dark and you'll never be completely light. You'll have both of these days. And so it's important to remember that, you know, when you go down these so counting phases where it's like, first this happened to me, and first I was treated like that, and then I had this experience that was terrible, you know, to also have that knowledge that, but yesterday I felt blessed, yesterday I felt lucky, you know, and that day can come again, that thing can happen again. I have been lucky before, that means I can also be lucky in the future. So know that you will have unlucky days and you'll have lucky days. And of course, try to foster a culture of hope for yourself, to find ways to maintain and feed hope. And I think also, in order to feed hope, you also have to roll your dice on some easy blessings. You know, there are some challenges that are more difficult than others. There are times where you'll be completely fine just rolling a 3 or a 4, and there'll be times you need to roll a 6, otherwise you fail. So they'll also roll your dice on the easy throws, you know, you also choose to do some easy throws during the day. Think of some easy gambles that you can make throughout the day that will have a high chance of success, you know, where small things you can do, that small risks you can take. Oh, no, I just go out and hope that the bus will come. And I know that the bus goes quite often, so I just go out and hope for the best. You know, those easy risks. Allow yourself to have those kind of easy gambles in life, you know, where you just trust in that things will work out, because you know that the chance things will work out is quite high. And don't just roll on the high or most difficult risks. You don't just throw yourself at the almost impossible risks, you know, where you have to roll a 6 or where you fail, or where there's only one bus going and you have to make that bus, and you don't know where it is, but you'll just take a risk and go out, and then you'll end up waiting outside for 3 hours, cursing yourself for being so stupid, or cursing the bus lines for going so rarely, so seldom. So regardless of that analogy, I think as an INFP, when you go through those phases where you just complain, and I want to explain why this is a dark side thing, why this is a malicious thing. I believe that when you complain, you curse. So a lot of the time when you complain at things, so the other day I was feeling lonely, oh so lonely. Luckily I've started using Type Match app, and I have to tell you, Type Match app has been redesigned with a completely new design. Thanks to Type Match app, I just matched with my new friend Marvel. Now Marvel, he is an INTJ, and we were matched because we have a lot of similar cognitive functions and personality traits, and because he seems to share a lot of the similar interests as I do. He also likes watching movies on Netflix, and he's black, and black is also the color of coffee, which is my favorite beverage. You can download Type Match app down below with the link. With that said, Marvel is already taken, so you can't have him. Sorry. A lot of the time when you curse at things, when you complain about things, you create your own demons and your own unhappiness and your own bad luck. A lot of time what you're doing is you're just pushing your bad luck further and further. It's the same as rolling a low throw on the dice, and then having a chance to be even more unhappy and then choosing to roll for even more unhappiness over and over again. You could say a lot of time you are creating a narrative, a scenario, and you become trapped in this narrative, and you become trapped in this state of misery and unhappiness, and you can trap other people in it too. You find yourself creating villains around you, you create enemies of parents, friends, and people around you. You create this idea that everyone around you is ill-intentioned, ill-willed, and that everyone around you is pushing you to fail, pushing you into further unhappiness, further misery. And this going into yourself and into this dark despair of everything is bad and everyone I know is evil and everyone I know is ill-willed and ill-intentioned is hurting you and is hurting other people. Because I think a lot of time words have power, and what we say about other people also becomes what other people are. If you say to somebody that they are stupid, they might choose to believe you. If you say to somebody that they are clumsy, they might choose to think that they are clumsy, and they might start acting more clumsy, more stupid, because the fact that you said so. So also recognize that your words have power, and what you throw out into the world, the intentions you read into situations, the things you wish for will come true, no matter if you wish for luck or whether you wish for misfortune. So recognize that as an INFP gone dark, you can wish for misfortune both for yourself and for other people, and you can create the dark days and dark destinies, you can bring bad luck just as you can bring good luck. Because I want you to remember that INFPs, when light, INFPs in a flow state, bring luck, are lucky charms, are people that, through their good intentions, good hope, optimism, and trust, and ability to forgive, create heroes, create good people, create good environments, healthy environments, peaceful situations, harmony, and situations where people can rest and relax and feel good. INFPs, when in a flow state, push and motivate everyone around them to feel better and to be better and set a higher barrier and a higher level and higher standard for everyone, ethically, morally, socially, and intuitively. You are a person that inspires people to dream bigger, hope bigger, and be better. And so recognize and push yourself to be that person as often as possible. Be the person that chooses to roll for fortune, that chooses to roll for happiness. Don't be the person that chooses to roll for evil, chooses to roll for darkness, chooses to roll for misery. And recognize when you are in a narrative where you feel pulled to do so, and where you feel like you just want to see where the end is, you know. Because I think there is, when you stare at the abyss, when you feel like there is a dark, when you feel like there is an evil in the world, I think there is also a kind of fascination and a curiosity to see what's down there. How far can I go? How miserable can I get? How bad can I get? How unlucky can I be? You know, if this is how unlucky I've been so far, okay, what else can happen to me? You know, so I recognize that curiosity, I recognize that fascination is there, and climb above that narrative. And I think there is a quote from J.K. Rowling, another INFP personnel type, that it's really interesting in this light, because J.K. Rowling, she was in that stage, you know. She was there, she was broke, she had no money, she had no published books, and she was getting nowhere, and she felt completely stuck. And then she realized, you know, when she was at that bottom, and she was like, okay, now I've gone all the way down to that abyss, and now I realize, well, now that I've been there, it can't get any worse. Now, up is the only way I can go. And so I want you to recognize that this is as dark as you can get. At this point, this level, this is as dark as you can get. And now, up is the only way you can go. Choose to hit the bottom, or to stay at the bottom where you are right now, and then to climb higher and higher and higher. And to, when you can, roll for luck, roll for happiness, and roll for good fortune for yourself and for the friends and people around you.